taken the time out of your business schedule to come out and be witness to this event that is going to take place this afternoon. If this is your first time here, you're in for a treat. You are certainly in for a treat. Last year was my first year here in this room, and I've been, Esther and I have been talking about it all year. And I'm so delighted that we had the opportunity to come back. For those of you who are visiting us here, I'd like to extend an invitation to all of you to visit with us on Wednesday noon for our noonday Bible study, and also at 7 p.m. Bible study. We have Sunday prayer school beginning on Sunday morning at 9:30 a.m. and our worship service at 10:45. I invite all of you who have a special invitation from me to come and be my guest on Sunday morning. So again, I just want to say thank you all for being here, and we're going to no end for a treat. Thank you so very much.
Say, behold, I have seen a son of Jesse, the Bethlehemite, that is kind and made and mighty valiant man, a man of walk, a prudent, a malice, and a kindly person, and the Lord is with him. Wherefore Saul sent men's messengers unto Jesse and said, send me David. And Jesse took an ass laid with bread, a bottle of wine, a kid, and sent them by David, his son, to Saul. And David came to Saul and stood before him, and he loved him greatly. He became a famous comrade. the evil spirit from God was upon Saul, that David took the harp and played with his hand. And Saul was refreshed and was ready, and the evil spirit departed from him. God's word for God's people.
Power and strength. We Then we have our parents, to some organizations, please stand. We have back officers here. Stand to the family, he's here. We have members of Mount Zion, please stand. Thank you so very, very much. Hey, I'm gonna tell you about the dynamic duo. And the dynamic duo. Mr. Daniel E. Robinson. You know you're a dynamic duo. David E. Robinson.
Thank you. Thank you. did I tell you? Must I say more? Must I say more? Anybody don't like it, don't believe. Well, since nobody got up there, people have an ambition. And if you do get up there, you remember that story they said, I know a man in Galilee, somebody needs to go tell somebody. You get up and go on cell phone, you need to go and tell somebody, they need to come see this second part. Amen. Amen. Somebody need to know. I mean, this is well kept. It's a well kept. Somebody, give them another hand. Come on.
I was here the first time, and what a delight it was. This is one of the more cultural events. And, you know, the church needs culture.
Amen.
I said the church needs culture.
Amen.
And now young people need to be exposed to something other than hip-hop. Can I get a witness? I want to take this opportunity to ask a couple of our deacons to come forward. And we're going to have two trays, one on either side. And I want one standing at our desk, so we want to come across here, and one to stand here. And you might be asking, why two trays? Well, I'm going to pull right. I am the pastor here. I don't take too many liberties, but today I'm going to take some liberty. We're going to have one trade for Mount Zion Scholarship Fund, but then we're going to have another trade for this office. You can't go anywhere and hear this caliber of music for free. We don't charge anything, they're not charging anything. But I'm going to pick the one off of the Senator Anita. I'm going to give $50 just to kick it off. And most of y'all will give 5 or 10 or 20 or 25. All right, feel free to do so. Whatever. And then I'm going to kick off the Mount Zion Scholarship Fund with another 50. All right? Now, I'm not asking you to do what I do. You know what you can do. But for Mount Zion, if you are making a donation to the scholarship fund, you may want to use the regular envelope. You want to get credit for it, tax write-off. All right? But for Sinfonia, just write the check. I'll put your cash. I'm just going to put the cash, this check, the $50 made available to the office. Now, where are the trailers? Yeah, I want you to stand right here, up here close. Give him one of those straight. And we're going to do this in a very orderly fashion. I just want one tray there and one there. One is going to be for the orchestra. He's the orchestra over there. This is for the scholarship fund for Mount Zion. And we will be giving yet another scholarship in memory of Ulyssia Denson, the daughter of Sister Denson here. Now, her daughter was a member of this group while she lived, and she was quite a very valuable member of that group. And if you read in her books, there have been more than 1,000 young people who have been exposed by having the opportunity to play with this particular orchestra. And certainly they are worthy of community support. Am I right? Yeah, don't think y'all make me think I'm an out of order. You know, I don't know what it is, but black folk have a way of getting quiet when they start talking about me. I ain't never seen the trailer. But anyway, which one did you say these were? You see. Now see that? You don't know what you are. Look.
They know.
He will be receiving money from all. Archer. This will be for the Mount Zion Scholar. And I want to put that for Mount Zion, and this is for the orchestra. Anyway, now, we're going to do this very quick. Everyone to my left, if you just stand, if you have anything, if you don't, we're just glad to have it. Come on around. You stand over here with me right now.
I'm home.
Yeah, stand right there so they won't have to cut across. Everyone in the center aisle, if you just go to that aisle there. Bless this orchestra as well as bless our young people, because they are not only our future, but they are our present. Simple Nia, what's on the program? If you're writing a check, make the check payable to Simple Nia. Let me thank everyone for being so nice and so kind as to contribute to the scholarship fund and certainly to this very worthy orchestra. And at this time, I'm going to turn the mic back over to our MC. Yes, the MC. He's going to call for prayer.
this time, I'm going to ask Reverend Jackson to come up.
I know that you have joined me. And I pray that I become the president of the Lord. And I pray you minister to me while the music was praying. That's all the heavens sitting there. Y'all can see it, but I got heavens sitting right there. And took all in me to hold my peace because I'm on them to jump up and holler, you know? But I was feeling mighty good right there. I don't know what you feel, but I feel the presence of the Lord. Amen. Come on, give the Lord a hand.
Thank you so very much. So very much. You know, it's amazing. When I was in school, in elementary school, we had to have a field trip. And we had a field trip to go to the city auditorium to see the Lounge Symphony concert. We had to pay, and we used to kind of watch to see what we see in it. And I didn't see it. And it's amazing. And now we're able to come and see us for free. And that should be worth a hand right there. And say, amen.
Thank you.
everybody called you on the telephone and called him out. But y'all think about that, to do that. But one thing about it, I do, I know you're going to tell them about it when you get home, later on, right? Oh, this is where it's talking about. Well, tell you. Thank you.
Thank you. Our final selection we will play is known as our Symphonia theme. This is from William Grant Still, black composer, this African-American symphony. This is just an excerpt of it. And just like Interlochen Music Camp up in Michigan has a theme made from Howard Hanson's second symphony, The Romantic, Symphonia started as a summer camp, and we decided to have a theme as well, especially commemorating 25 years, and here from now on, we close our program with that.
And I'm the violin. Khalilah Mack, and a friend of Viola. My name is Vivian Akoy, and I'm from Viola.
My name is Khalilah
Mack, and I'm from Viola. My name is Jerry Griffin, and I play the cello.
My name is Janady Wah, and I play the cello.
My name is Diva Buck, and I play the bass.
Schools of
prison pipeline agenda. You know black kids can't learn anything about humanities, orchestra. They don't care about all that. But if they see what we're playing here, and some of these teachers play a lot of my music, say, oh, black kids aren't interested in playing string instruments. Please, citizens, please be vocal in getting these programs back in school, especially in our neighborhood, because we've got a lot of good music. Our kids can go a long way. And also, you heard about the Georgia takeover of schools. You know what that's going to be. We got to be out to the polls to vote, because, you know, they turned everything into a charter school, a so-called troubled schools, a failing schools, or whatever. You know they will cut out music. They will cut out foreign language. They will cut out art. They may even cut out band. Well, you know, band has a connection to football team, so they might not cut that out. They'll cut out everything that makes a kid excited about going to school, and we can guarantee that while certain politicians and their friends get profits and everything. But I want to thank all of you for your support, and Mrs. Robinson wants to say something else, too.
I just wanted to recognize another one of our alumni who now has joined as one of our instructors, Ms. Cookie Robinson.
And I forgot to mention the three little children you saw on stage, those are our junior orchestra. She just started, what, last month? I think she just started last month. So we have a program. Interested, our information should be on the program. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Dean. Thank you so much. I'm getting ready to do the remarks. We're going to move on. I thank you all. I know you enjoyed it. I thank you all for putting up with me. And I thank you all for being so good and allowing so good. Thank you. At this time, I'm going to ask Mayor Dempsey. That's the very best to come and give her a remark. Follow our pastor. Give her a hand as she comes.
Thank you, Orchestra. You enlighten us and you thrill us with your talents. You warm our hearts by your talents and by the skills of your songs that you play for us. We warm our hearts very, very deeply from that family. Will you count? They still keep working. further extended to the Marshall families for your continued support and prayers. A special salute to Mother Millie. I'm so glad that you're here, Mother Millie, 99 years old. Your presence this evening, I will forever cherish. To Bobby, thank you, Ms. Mann. She's the church secretary, and she has been God's blessing to us in providing administrative support and government. The caterer is here, Ms. Vicki Randall. She is honoring her with her gift as a caterer. To my pastor, Reverend Dr. Henry Wise Jones, thank you for your love of the gospel that has been nothing other than inspiration. It wants my heart that you love this book. You know, it wants to get to another step. You know that, right? Okay. A Mount Sinai family. You can wave to your hand to family members. I see certain family members. I'm so glad that you all were able to attend. You continue to strengthen me in my walk of faith in Jesus Christ. And for this, I'm eternally grateful to Alicia Robinson and David Robinson III, who are a dynamic duo. And we thank you for all your hard work for the students. And I want to take this minute to thank Mount Zion family members. You warm my heart that you took time to visit with us. Thank you. I have one notice to close friends. Will my close friends give his name? Yes, Lord. Thank you so very, very much. And we acknowledge all of your issues. Thank you.
Again, we thank all of you, the Mount Zion Knights and the family members of Ms. Denson and certainly the community members who have come out to witness this very wonderful presentation in the music here tonight. I am inspired again, especially when I see a young girl, very young. How old are you, dear? 10? See that? Yeah, she's doing something. And how you, young man, I think I asked you to go to mission 14. Stand up there. Coming to me over here. this office to Mount Zion. And I said, by all means, and I know that this has to be an annual event. Last year was our first time, and we might have had 50 people here. But I see more than 50 tonight. And I think it will grow, and we're going to make it grow. You know, we need to talk about the positive things that are going on in our community. We always see the negative stuff. The news is just filled. But ain't no Atlanta Journal Constitution going to be here to cover this. You dig me?
Yeah.
I'm telling you, racism is still very much alive. And I always define it by saying it's the eternal joke played on conscious culture at the expense of unconscious biology. So, that being said, I want to ask Mr. Robinson to come forward. I don't know how much is in here. We didn't count it. We want to leave that to you and your gang. But I tell you what, from what I can see, I think you're going to be more than pleased. Let the church say it with you. I also want to thank all of you for your contribution. This was not just Mount Zion, this was a community.
Yes.
Mount Zion just happens to be the location, and we certainly want to thank everybody who contributed to the success of this program tonight, especially again, these wonderful young people. And let's just give them one more good round. The reception will follow immediately.